Today I'm going to show you what to do if you get an eviction notice. Hey creator, I'm Ian Corzine, your social media lawyer. Today we're going to be talking about what to do if you get an eviction notice. There's been a lot of talk in the news about increasing evictions across the globe. Now I hope you never get an eviction notice, but if you do, I wanted to make this video to teach you what to do if you get an eviction notice. Now, if you are a renter of an apartment or a home, you pay rent. You pay an amount of money per month for your rent. Hopefully you've had an okay time during this difficult time for our whole world and you're able to pay your rent. But what happens if you are not able to pay your rent? You don't have enough money, the money is gone, and so you can't pay rent. Well, then there's a problem, and that problem is the eviction process. Eviction describes a set of laws that allow a landlord to get a tenant out of the premises if he hasn't paid rent or he's breached a material term of the lease. Now, eviction refers to a court process, and it's very important to understand this, that eviction laws vary from county to state to country. So you really have to be familiar with your own eviction laws before you take the steps needed to either avoid the eviction or to fight the eviction in a court of law. However, even though eviction laws vary throughout the world, there is a general framework for eviction, the eviction process. And that framework is, first, the landlord must give you written notice that he acknowledges you haven't paid rent, or he must give you notice that you've breached a material term of the lease and he wants you to get out of the premises or pay the amount that's due within a specified period. Now, if you do not vacate the premises or pay the amount due within that specified period that's in the notice, then the landlord has the right to bring an eviction lawsuit against you. And typically, the landlord files that lawsuit in a court of law, gets attorney involved, serves you with the lawsuit, and it's up to you to respond. Now, you as the tenant have a right to oppose the eviction in writing. You can assert a series of defenses against the eviction action. You could say, for example, that the landlord failed to follow the rules to properly evict you. You could say the landlord failed to maintain your property the way he should have, or you can say the landlord discriminated against you. Now, after the tenant has asserted defenses to the eviction action and brought some evidence forward to justify those defenses, and the landlord has his or her evidence, then comes resolution. Resolution of the eviction action could take place before a judge or a jury. There could be a judgment against you, or maybe you win the case. But before the judgment comes out, you could also enter into a settlement with the landlord. Now that you understand the eviction process, we need to move on to what you do if you actually get an eviction notice. And I have three steps here. The first step is to pay rent. If you can pay the rent that's due, you should. There's a variety of things you can do to get the rent paid. One is you could negotiate with the landlord for a lower amount due at this time and then pay off the remaining balance over time throughout the months that you're in the premises. If you enter into some agreement with the landlord, make sure it's in writing. You don't want it to be later on in time the landlord says, I never agreed to this, and then commences an eviction action again. The other thing you can do is just work harder, get another job to be able to pay off your rent. You could borrow from family or friends, or you could sell some of your personal items to make up that rent. If you cannot pay off the rent in the first step, the second step is to seek government assistance or nonprofit assistance. There are a lot of organizations out there, including the government, that will help you pay your rent. You just have to find them. The best place to find them is to go to rentassistance.us. Type that into the search browser. There's hundreds of different organizations out there that are dedicated to helping people who are in a difficult situation and can't pay rent. You can apply and then you can get some resources, some financial resources to help you pay rent and to stay in your place. The other thing you can do, which I just did, is you can search in the Google search browser, rent assistance near me, and you can find some local programs. They could be city, county, state, you know, government programs that will help you pay the rent for your premises. I'm gonna put links to these sites in the description section, but I really encourage you to go searching. There is a lot of resources out there to help people that are struggling to pay their rent, and I definitely don't want you evicted. If you believe that you have a good defense to an eviction action after you've received an eviction notice, go to step number three, which is hire a lawyer. There are tenant lawyers out there that have unique knowledge that will help you win your eviction action. Sometimes they'll help you assert your defenses and delay the action until you can get in a better position either to pay rent or to move out. But oftentimes this is a good decision to make to hire a tenant lawyer. It costs a little bit of money, but in the long run, it really helps to understand the law. And if you're looking for recommendations for lawyers around you, you can go to lawhelp.org. They will provide you with a list of lawyers that are qualified to represent you in an eviction action. I'll put the link to lawhelp.org down below, but it's also important to understand that even if you don't have money for a lawyer, this particular website has lawyers that do work pro bono. That means they do the work free of charge. So you're going to want to go to lawhelp.org to find lawyers that are specialized in fighting eviction notices. You know, you have another option if you cannot afford the rent for your apartment or your home. You can get out of the lease entirely. If you want to know the process for getting out of the lease and not paying the remainder on the lease, you should watch my video right here. And as always, as you watch, I'm going to be at iancorzine.com to answer any social media law questions you have.